from the 2.4. And I'm on that bullshit again. And I'm on that bullshit today, right? Y'all know how I do, IOTBA. Y'all know how I do. Ride with me. Huh? Turn that shit up. Turn your bitch to a bust down. Her one, her two, nigga, touchdown. Free cash, I can't wait till he touchdown. Free E, I can't wait till he touchdown. Hey, hey, ride with me, IOTBA. Y'all know how I do.
I must address the bullshit.
Man, we on Fishbowl Radio Network, do you understand me?
Yes.
This award-winning radio show, IOTBA Radio, you understand me?
Yes.
Shout out to my nigga Sit-Starter up in this motherfucker.
Motherfuckers.
Man, shout out to everybody up in this bitch. Shout out to my nigga JG of EntitledKings.com up in this motherfucker.
Entitled Kings, we in the building, baby, JG. You know?
Shout out to my nigga Money Monk up in this motherfucker. Shout out to my nigga Piff up in this motherfucker. And shout out to the beautiful Miosa up in this motherfucker. Of course, and shout out to my nigga Co Heezy up in this motherfucker. HeezyTV.com up in this bitch. You understand me? So let me ask y'all something real quick. Y'all used to watch wrestling, everybody in there?
Hell yeah.
Do everybody in there remember The Rock? You remember how The Rock used to say, I got millions and millions of The Rock fans?
Yeah.
Well, we got thousands and thousands of IOTBA radio fans. And I want everybody on Fishbowl Radio Network, IOTBA Radio, the biggest internet radio network in the world, get JG, Money Moke, Coheezy, Miosha, Piff, a big old motherfucking hand clap for that, goddamn. Man, we appreciate everybody being in this business tonight, you understand me? But hold up, though. Shout out to everybody that's on IOTBA Radio on Fishbowl Radio Network. Man, shout out to everybody on Facebook right now, do you understand me, who watching us? Because y'all are truly the best of the best. Hey, yo, shit, start up.
Yes, sir.
Give them a motherfucking hand clap for that, goddamn. Man, this is what we do. But if it weren't for everybody who listen to us, I'm talking about the thousands and thousands of people who listen to us on IOTBA Radio and the big response that we get on Facebook. Man, IOTBA, we won't be IOTBA up in this motherfucker, you understand me? Shit started, what it do, pimp?
Man, long hard day.
I'm talking about, man, this Wednesday, man, they call us Mr. Monday through Thursday up in this motherfucker. You understand me? If y'all don't know, they also call me Mr. I'm on that bullshit again. Mr. Undeniable. Mr. 2.14. Mr. These niggas can't fuck with me. On my worst day, you understand me?
Talk that shit.
Man, I appreciate y'all for being up in this motherfucker tonight. And say, man, let me get right to it with you, JG.
Yeah, get to it.
Because me and you, we always talking on the phone. And we talking about boxing, you understand?
Yeah.
And you are such a big fan of Aries Lande Laura.
Yeah.
I'm talking about when we were just talking like an hour ago.
Yeah.
And you brought up this kid. You say he was robbed against Paul Williams.
Robbed.
And you said he was robbed against Canelo Alvarez.
Robbed, absolutely.
You also, hold on, and everybody look at JG.
Yeah.
Hey, you also said, shout out to EntitledKings.com and this motherfucker, but you also said you think that Aries Lande Lara is the best 154-pound fighter in the world.
Absolutely, and I can tell you exactly why.
Tell me why, JG.
If you just look at his style and who he's fought and how he's fought them, and how many rounds they've won against him, it'll show he's the best 154. Nobody, I don't think there's nobody that can, he might as well go up and wait. People are running from him. Your boy, Andre,
they running from him.
Demetrius Andre fought Aries Lande Laura in the amateurs.
Laura
Clown in the amateurs, he beat Andre. Andre said he wanted to fight somebody out of Ronnie Shields camp when the Charlos was there.
Yeah.
He ran from Laura. He fought Canelo. And I do feel like, you know.
He beat Canelo. You feel like it. But you're right, it's a lot of people around the world. It's down the middle, 50-50. A lot of people say Laura won, a lot of people say Canelo won. Carry on.
I did. Yeah. I mean, and another thing is this, man. He's slick, man. That Cuban style of fighting, man. He's a southpaw. He's real, real slick, and he hit hard. And he's not, and he's making you move. He hit you move, and he don't get hit. You go look at his percentage of getting hit. It's better than Floyd Mayweather's. And numbers don't lie. Yeah, well, look it up.
Talk this shit.
He got a better percentage of not getting hit than Floyd Mayweather, who we all know is probably the greatest defender in boxing ever.
Okay, but hold up. We're going to get back to that in a minute.
Yeah.
Show everybody that shirt you got on right there.
Title Kings, man. Legends.
Let's talk about that. Tell everybody about the Title Kings, Legends, and TitleKings.com.
And TitleKings.com. We are, basically what we do free advertising marketing, and we also carry a blog website as well. We have a website where you can download music, you can check all the latest news. We also have a shop on there. We have a t-shirt line, clothing line that we just got started. We've been around for about 3 years as far as a company and a brand. It started me, a friend, and my cousin, Money Mo, shout out to him, and Pilt, Hollywood Pilt. We got everything together, man. It just the title is the meaning of it. Title Kings. You're entitled to be a king or a queen in your own mind. You know, in your situation, it shouldn't judge you that, you know. It's a mindset. So that's where the name came from. We ran with it. And here we are, man. 2016, we're making moves.
So tell everybody, we know it's entitledkings.com, but tell us, give a little bit more in depth with it. What do you do?
So what we do is this. Small businesses, people that are trying to pursue a career, you know, whether they have their own business or any kind of brand that they're trying to market, we're another outlet to the internet. So for you to have to go pay somebody to market yourself online, with us is absolutely free. You know, you register, you subscribe with us, we basically the information, artists, you know, from portraits, people that draw, from people that make music, from people that do all different types of stuff, barbers, beauticians. It doesn't matter what you do. Anybody got anything going that's positive and they're trying to promote it to the internet, you should register with us. It's absolutely free. And I mean that, absolutely free. It costs nothing.
Okay, so like it's sports, gossip?
Sports, gossip. I mean, anything that you got going. I mean, as far as your business, if you have a small business, as far as you're a barber, if you're trying to get your music out there, or you're a producer, you know, anything, you have to pay people to be on it. You have to pay to be on the internet nowadays. With us, what we do, it helps us help you. We want to get out there. We want to help people. We want to help the small people that don't have the exposure that they know. Help them get to the top. That's all it is, man. It's absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. It costs absolutely nothing. People say, how do y'all benefit from it? Well, we benefit from people clicking on our website, and it helps us get exposure. You help us get exposure, we help you get exposure. It's hand in hand.
So how long have y'all actually been doing this?
We've been doing this for a solid 3.5 years.
Okay.
That's solid. That's all the way down to the day, today.
You also do interviews too, right?
Absolutely. We do interviews. We've done a couple different interviews. You know, we had a pleasure interviewing you, which was a great interview. That should be coming pretty soon. Y'all stay tuned to that. Y'all can only find that on entitledkings.com. Like I said, when it comes out, we will be doing some advertising with that. We got Lil Buss, which is a rapper out of Allen, Texas. He's doing his thing, up-and-coming rapper.
Shout out to
Lil Buss, man. He's a hard worker. He's trying to get to the next level. G-Hood, you know, the whole Cloud 9. He got his interview coming as well. So we do interview. I mean, like I said, it's another way to expose you. People want to see you on TV. They want to see what you look like. They want to hear you. And that's what we do. You know, you get in contact with us and we make it happen.
Talk that shit.
Yeah.
But how, you know, I mean, you really connect this because you really, really, really love boxing.
Absolutely. I love boxing. Boxing is something that I wish I could have done as a kid, you know. And I'm at that point to where I studied the sport so much. My kids, you know, I have two sons, they're going to be boxers.
Don't talk that shit.
You see what I'm saying? So I studied the sport, and I understand the sport, and I think it's very important. It's something it's really something you can learn every day, man. It's like studying a book, but you're studying the sport, you know, from whatever you're looking at. Weight classes, fighters, different styles. It's one of those things.
As a person who loves boxing and studies the sport, I got a question to ask you about these fighters, up-to-date fighters, even like Danny Garcia,
Keith Thurman,
and all the other boys that's new to the game. Why do you think these guys don't want to fight certain fighters and they cherry-picking fighters who they want to fight? And, you know.
Well, you know what? I think it's this. It comes down to building your record. You know,
do you think they're scared, or do you think they?
Not necessarily. I think in some sense, some fighters you do have a scaredness. Because the thing of it is, you're undefeated. That's not something you want.
Hold up.
You don't want an L.
But I want you to tell everybody again, where can they find this?
TitleKings.com. Like I said, we have a live stream box coming pretty soon, man. IOTBA, we appreciate the love, man. Y'all go find us. We'll have a get together and have a party. We do parties as well, man.
These, I'm telling y'all, these t-shirts they got is fly as fuck.
Yeah, check out the legend line. Like I said, man, shout out to everybody that's fucking with us.
Say, this motherfucking shirt right here, dope as fuck, IOTBA. And everybody around the world, whoever made this shirt was a fucking genius who came up with this logo right here.
Yeah. Hey, we appreciate y'all. Like I said, we will be back. We'll be back to talk some more boxing, man, and let y'all know.
I ain't through with you yet.
Yeah.
We're going to get back to you because we're going to get back to you on TylerKings.com, too.
Absolutely.
But we got G-Hood up in this bitch, you understand me? But y'all know how we do. We got G-Hood up in this motherfucker. We finna go to the break real quick, come back. Y'all know how I do. Mr. 2-1-4, and I'm on that bullshit again. Ride with me, IOTBA. Y'all know how I do. We got G-Hood up in this motherfucker, live and direct now. You understand me? Y'all know we fuck with this shit every night up in this motherfucker. Monday through Thursday. You understand me? What did he say? Huh? Turn your bitch to a bus down. Hug one, hug two, nigga, touchdown. Free cash, I can't wait till he touchdown. Free E, I can't wait till he touchdown. Hey, ride with me, IOTBA. We got hood up in this motherfucker tonight, rocking this bitch. Now we up now. My nigga started from the bottom. Ride with me, IOTBA. Got your Zach up in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Pack right up in this motherfucker. Cloud 9 up in this bitch. My nigga Cohesy over there for the ocean. You know what I'm saying? Cohesy still filming. The ocean filming. Got my nigga Killer Cal up in this motherfucker. Salute. Say, bring that right now. We got a salute. Open them niggas up right here.
The whole squad in, bro.
Y'all know how we do, IOTBA. Mr. 214, Mr. Undeniable. We got G-Hood up in this motherfucker. Do you understand me? Cloud 9 Money Gang. Well, I'm still with the clique.
You already know the same niggas I started with.
What I'm talking about? That fucking man coming up.
You feel
me? Y'all know how we do that Cohesy up here. This is another badass video you did called Cohesy is the truth. Nigga, the truth. And I'm talking about the absolute. You know what I'm saying? Truth. T-R-U-F. Truth. I'm talking about. Shout out to my man, a revenue. Shout out to his revenue up in this motherfucker. I seen that nigga when I was at the media press. You know what I'm saying? Doing that Canelo shit, you understand? He was in that bitch too.
Yeah, he fucked with his
people. Yeah. IOTBA. Nigga, I got a bitch too. Fuck you mean? Ride with me, IOTBA. Yes. Fuck you mean, nigga? On this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying?
They call
him Mr. Fuck You Mean, you understand me? Mr. Touchdown, you understand me? Mr. Walk on Water, you understand me? Mr. Twin Cities, you understand me? Mr. Minneapolis, Minnesota up in this motherfucker, you understand me? Everybody around the world, give T-Hood a big old motherfucking hand clap for that goddamn. Damn, we appreciate you coming back up in this motherfucker.
I don't know
if you know this. This shit right here, this song is requested. Every motherfucking night we in here. We play it anyway. Cause we on the biggest internet radio network in the world. So this ain't just in the 214 and the local shit.
Right.
We all the way across the pond and everybody fuck with this shit right here. Touchdown, bro. Like real talk, bro. They fuck with that. They own that shit. Niggas be like, where's this nigga at? You know what I'm saying? I be telling people. Cause they be like, hug one, hug two, nigga. Why stop playing with me, man? Say, you the absolute truth.
Yep.
And I'm Bugsy, and we really appreciate you coming back. Man, what's been up? Last time we had you up in here, You told us that you was going on tour.
Yeah. I had one on tour with Young Simmie, artist out of Florida. And I had one on tour with him. It was just like a little Texas tour. We only did 3 dates. We did San Antonio, Dallas, and Houston. And we did that over the weekend. That shit was cool, you know what I'm saying? The squad we had rolled out, we had did it. That shit was smooth.
Money gang up in this motherfucker. The whole clique up in this bitch. Killer Cal. You know what I'm saying? Young Zach, you got Money Moke, you got JG. You know what I'm saying? You got Cohesy up in this motherfucker. Like everybody up in this bitch tonight. Yeah, Piff up in this motherfucker. You understand? Everybody in this bitch, dog. And that's love right there. But I want to get into it because I know you recently had some troubles.
Yeah.
You know, where you got caught into a situation.
Yeah.
And you know, can you give us a little backstory on what went down and how is the situation now?
Me and my nigga Red had went to Vegas and shit for a little vacation and shit. And then on the way back and shit, we had got pulled over and shit. And when we had got pulled over and shit, we had some guns and shit in the car. So you know how that shit go. So, you know, boom, boom, boom. And I was already on the run for some shit. I had been on the run for like 8 months. But I was smooth, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't getting in no trouble or none of that. I was out the way. I was just doing the music and just chilling, you know what I'm saying? Then, you know, on my way back from Vegas, that shit happened. And, you know, but everything got dropped. We beat all that shit. Like, all that shit's clear. I'm good. Like, no gun cases. All that shit's dropped. All that shit's dismissed. I'm still going through the situation that I was on the run for. I'm still going to court for that shit. But that shit's cool, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm just going to get put back on probation. Everything's going to be good.
But everything's been clear with the gun case.
Everything clear with the gun case. Gun case is clear. I'm good.
So let's get into it, because I know on Halloween, I seen a video.
Yeah, man.
Called Halloween.
I just dropped a video.
Get into that.
On Halloween, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my nigga Heezy, HeezyTV.com. My nigga Heezy shot the video. And really, shit, it was just one of them situations like motherfuckers was just sitting around like, shit. Man, Halloween coming up, you feel me? You need to do Halloween for Halloween. You know?
Yeah.
It's like, fuck it. Come on, let's do it. But shit, you know what I'm saying? We had really chopped it, and I was just telling bro, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to do, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to do no simple videos, you know what I'm saying? I want to put some thought behind this shit, you feel me? So, motherfuckers just, you know,
video was
together.
Crazy.
I appreciate that shit. I appreciate that shit.
I was just downstairs telling Cody, I'm like, damn, dog. You are the absolute truth, too.
Yeah, that nigga
that video
crazy.
Was crazy. Yeah, it was sick,
Heezy,
bro.
My nigga go crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying? We just been working. Like,
but you steady be dropping videos, though, G. I'm always seeing something new with you, and you always got something new going on.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep this shit, you know what I'm saying, keep my face out there so motherfuckers can really just gravitate to this shit, this Cloud 9 shit that we got going on, and just really push this shit, you know what I'm saying?
Well, tell everybody who don't know about Cloud 9 and Money Gang.
Man, Cloud 9 Money Gang, man, your title King G-H60D, man, it's a movement, you know what I'm saying? We just all one big family. We all been kicking it, you know what I'm saying? Since I moved to Texas, I've been kicking it with these niggas on some whole other shit. And then, you know what I'm saying, we all got together on the music tip and just been just pushing, you know what I'm saying? We all done had our little troubles, though, with the law and all type of crazy weird shit, but you know, we still standing and we still strong, so everybody's still pushing.
I want everybody to know on Fishbowl Radio Network, man, we got G-Hood up in this motherfucker. G-Dollar. You understand, man? We glad to have G-Hood back up in this bitch Money Game. We got the title Kings.com up in this motherfucker. Cloud 9 up in this motherfucker. HeezyTV.com up in this motherfucker. You understand
we
me?
Dicking this motherfucker.
Shout out to my nigga Young Troy. Who tuning in right now in this motherfucker. My nigga, yo, Troy up in this motherfucker.
Tracks.
You know what I'm saying? I fucks with the whole squad. You know what I'm saying? Because last time, see, everybody here now. You know what I'm saying? Last time, you know, it was G-Hood and Cohesy, Killer Kyle was up in this motherfucker too. I was telling a story about when I came to, Plano.
Oh, yeah.
When I had all that red.
Oh, see,
I didn't know where I was. Say, bro, you talking about a scary experience. You understand me? Sitting around a bunch of, you know what I'm saying, real niggas. Yeah. You understand me? Like, who rep that shit for real. You know what I'm saying? And I'm the brightest nigga in the room. My nigga Young Troy, had to hurry up and get me the fuck up out of there. I told that nigga, get me the fuck up out of here. You understand me? Like, real tough. Say, like, nah, I ain't bullshit, bro. Say, like, niggas gotta know where they at, man, and where you going to.
Yeah, you was good, though, because you was with us, so you had your
past. I know I was good, but nigga, you know what I'm saying? Niggas was like, yeah. I was like, okay. So, nigga, I tell me, nigga, I've been too bugged. It's like, fuck it. Nigga, it's time to go. Man, we got G-Hood up in this motherfucker. I had to tell that whole story.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
that is a true motherfucking story. But you got, you dropping, hold on, before I talk about this new project, this new project you got coming out, excuse me. Let's talk about Walk on Water.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because you just dropped that in May, right?
Yeah, I dropped Walk on Water in May and shit. Walk on Water's on iTunes, Spotify, all the digital distribution, all that shit, CD Baby, all that shit. Like, you know, that shit on all that shit. You can listen to that shit.
So what was the concept of Walk on Water? Because I'm going to get to your new project in a minute, because I want to know what the concept of Walk on Water to a lot of people who don't know.
That shit was just basically doing some shit like, just keep faith, you feel me? Like, no matter what you going through, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you trying to get somewhere in life or you got a certain obstacle you trying to overcome, you can do that shit. Just like when dude was walking on water. But then as soon as he started losing his hope and his faith, he started drowning. So it's like, shit, you can do whatever you need to do. You got to walk on water. If you really believe you can walk on water, you going to walk on that shit. That's what it was.
Because I see you as really grinding. Yeah. I see it's a method to your madness and what you're doing, because you steady dropping this new shit.
Yeah, mama, I got hella shit. I got another project that's done too, but I'm going to put this other shit out before I put that out.
So, yeah, let's get into this project you finna jump off. Eternal Affairs. God damn.
Yeah,
you just dropped one in May. Now you finna drop another one.
Yeah.
You know, when is Eternal Affairs dropping?
Thanksgiving. This is
gonna be
EP. Okay.
Okay, but still though, tell everybody about the Eternal Affairs.
Shit, really, I just got inspired watching the movie.
Okay.
And then it was the movie, you know what I'm saying? If you've seen the movie, a lot of shit that was happening in the movie, in some type of way, it was kind of had shit that was going on with me and my niggas, that we just be the case and crooked cops, all type of weird shit. So I just was like, fuck it, I'm gonna just do the boom. I did like 6 songs one night in the studio, shit just all fit. I was like, fuck it, boom, boom, boom. It was just some quick shit. Put it out.
Your work ethic is amazing to me, because you just told me you got another project you're going to wait to drop. You're going to drop Eternal Affairs.
Yeah, that G.
Tell everybody about your work ethic and what you do when you go in the studio to create your music.
Man, I just get high.
Flip through that shit. He did tell me. Flip through that shit, bro. Flip through it. Hold on, play that. Yep, hold on, love that, love that. And boom, there you go. You write the track to it right then. Simple as that, bro. That's how it is. All this shit you out here, that's how that shit got made, real talk. One night, one take, one night, all one time, boom, boom, boom. I didn't have to sit and think about the shit for 5 hours or shit. None of that weird shit, like that shit just all. So you don't write a piece of the song here and then write the other piece of the song later on down the road? No, it's right then and right there.
Because I always lose the feeling.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I've tried that. You know what I'm saying? Well, I might think of some shit, like right now. Like, I might do the radio interview with y'all and then think about some shit in my head and then go to the studio in 3 weeks and be like, and remember that shit and hear a beat and try to say it. And then sometimes the shit be going, sometimes it don't. When it don't go, I be like, fuck it, I just say that for another time. You know what I'm saying? But it just be like some shit I could go off of. Like, you know, I don't know. That would be weird, some weird shit, but that's just how my shit be coming about. You know?
Life experiences.
Yeah.
Real shit.
Yeah, just real shit.
Alright.
A lot of shit that be going on.
Okay.
So, as everybody know, the way I introduced you, you from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
St. Paul, I'm from St. Paul.
Oh, you from St. Paul?
Yeah, St. Paul. The Minneapolis, the other city.
Okay.
St. Paul, too.
Oh, you from St. Paul.
Yeah.
So, but still, being from St. Paul, you still are a Vikings fan, right?
Hell yeah.
Okay. I'm just asking.
Get into it.
I'm just saying.
Get into it.
I'm just saying. I just want to know.
Rocking with the whole squad.
I just want to know.
I just want to move on this side. I just want to know with the Minnesota Vikings starting out to such a hot start. I'm talking about, listen.
You got a lot of people on Facebook. I got a lot of people because I used to stand in Minneapolis. And one thing I learned about Minneapolis when I stayed up there when I was young, every street is an alphabetical order. You understand me? And I would stand up in Minnesota. This is why I got to despise a little bit for Minnesota. Because now I love Minnesota, the city, but I'm talking about the Vikings, the team, the football team. This is why I really don't like them like that. Because when I was standing up in Minnesota, that's when Randy Moss, we passed on Randy Moss, right? The Cowboys, we just passed on it. Minnesota got it right.
Oh, man.
I was staying up there. I was staying up there when he killed us on Thanksgiving, and I was staying around a bunch of Minnesota Viking fans, and they was on my ass, boy. Do you understand me? But let's get back to it. The Minnesota Vikings, G Hood, they started out 5-0, blazing. You know, look, that's how they traded for Sam Bradford. You understand? I'm just saying. They traded for Sam Bradford. You know, gave up a number one pick for this guy. You understand me? But the first five games, it looked like it was working. Yeah. They were 5-0. Adrian Peterson go down. You know, we like, oh shit, what's gonna happen to the Vikings? Then on this two-game losing streak. What's going on, G?
Our O-line trash ain't giving my man no time back there.
I mean, goddamn, the Minnesota Vikings.
They ain't giving my man no time back.
They are ranked 31st in offense, bro.
They ain't giving my nigga no time.
Damn.
I don't
understand how they started out 5-0.
The little time they was giving them, it was working. The little time they was giving them, their ass was working. But that shit ain't going to
shake. But no, you know what pissed me off about?
And we just lost Norm Turner, the offensive coordinator.
I like the Vikings, though, because staying up there, that made you have a little love for the team a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
I stopped watching.
That killed me, bro.
But they
fired the offensive coach. What do you think about what type of fucking move was that?
No, they didn't fire him. He resigned.
But why?
Because he's talking about some health issues and shit, but we needed him because he's good. So, shit.
But y'all still fired him too, though.
Yeah,
you
know? Yeah, I think I can.
So what you think about the Cowboys?
The Cowboys, you know, they doing their things right now, you feel me? But they got it. They just like Minnesota, shit. They didn't do it.
Was that playoff game?
Yes. Hold on. So let me ask you, because you can be biased because you're not a Cowboy.
Yeah.
Do you think Jerry Jones put Tony Romo back in the fucking game?
Nah, he's a goofy. Nah, he better keep the play. He better keep Dak in there. Keep the young boy in there.
You know, don't we see y'all pretty soon?
Yeah.
Cowboys versus Minnesota.
Anybody want to take? Anybody want to bet on Minnesota? I'm taking the bets. Anybody want to bet on Minnesota? I'm taking the bets.
Bring that ass here.
Oh, you think Minnesota's gonna beat the Cowboys?
We at home.
I'm taking your money. I'm gonna give me
some. What that mean? Cause y'all at home. I'm just
saying. It's an advantage.
That's good. Minnesota do got a badass defense though. If they all
got a nice stadium.
They got a
nice stadium.
They got a nice stadium.
We got a badass defense.
They do got a nice defense.
Yeah, the panel y'all want.
One defense.
Y'all got a nice defense. I ain't gonna be able to.
Dak's not gonna be able to do that shit. Our secondary gonna be eating that nigga shit up. Nah. That shit ain't gonna be out of work.
No. It ain't gonna happen like that.
And our linebacker's good. The E-King, I'm gonna just be running on us like the mud niggas.
You know, I heard about Minnesota, they got that real expensive paint on that hill, and that's what I heard.
One thing I first learned about when I stayed in Minneapolis, bro, like this is real tough, because I'm from Dallas. You know, I went up there the night, it was like 91.
You
would have
been, it
was crazy. Yeah, 92. Yeah, like it was popping up there, but one thing that fucked me up is niggas went with white women and white women went with niggas. Yeah. that fucked me up because I never seen that. But that was cool, right, though, because I had me a white girlfriend up there.
Yes.
In Minnesota, you know, like real talk. That was my first time opened up to interracial relationships. You know what I'm saying? I was like, okay, cool.
I ain't saying shit like that.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't, but I'm like, oh, flavors. You know what I mean? I don't discriminate in my big palm voice. I regulate at least say that. You understand me? Especially when you see just, I mean, because it's beautiful women out here, you understand me? Like, I know for women, because women think just like we think, you know? It's beautiful women out here, it's beautiful men out here. I know damn well women be saying, I want to fuck him. Just like a
yeah, they do.
Be saying, I want to fuck you. I know they do.
It's true.
We got a lady in the
building saying it was true.
It's
true.
So,
it's crack.
I be like, you know, but look, it's, it's good to be faithful. I'm not telling nobody not to be faithful. It's great to be. But I just wonder sometimes to myself. With all these beautiful women out here, and you know, women will say, with all these beautiful men out here, how can you just pick one? Because they like the Lay's potato chips. Remember that commercial, bet you can't try just one. Like, damn. like real talk.
No one takes this one.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Just like the his EP finna drop on Thanksgiving, Return of Affirms, boy. Bunch of furrows, boy.
Bunch of furrows.
Shout out to you dropping the Turner of Furrows. It's a 6-song EP in this motherfucker. You understand me? What's different about Turner of Furrows from Walk on Water? Like, what's the difference?
My beat selection. I fucked with different producers on this one. On Walk on Water, my nigga Bud out of Memphis did the majority of that shit. You know what I'm saying? So the sound was kind of one sound because it was the majority of his shit. But on Eternal Affairs, I got like 2-3 different producers that I ain't never fucked with.
So
the
sound was different?
Yeah, the sound was different.
Okay.
Shout out to my nigga Young Zach, aka Pack Rat up in this motherfucker. Pull a mic to you, Young Zach. What it do, Bill?
What's happening, man?
So that's my nigga Young Zach. See, that's how I met everybody. See, me and Young Zach, we used to work at this job. I ain't gonna say no name with a job, you know what I'm saying? They can fuck themselves. You understand me? Nigga on the big and better things. Yeah. You understand me?
Yep.
Me and my nigga Young Zach met up, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to my nigga Young Troy. That's how I met G Hood and them, you know what I'm saying? They had Money Gang, you know, 6 and 8, you know what I'm saying? You dropped that, you know what I'm saying? Him and Young Zach, I used to be saying, Young Zach, you know what I'm saying? Up there writing this shit. I seen them niggas one day, G Hood and them came up to him, and I don't know if it was Pimp, but it was another bright dude. It wasn't you, Pimp. It was another bright dude who was with you. I can't think of his name, though. And we was out there, we was, you know what I'm saying, doing our thing on lunch break and shit, you understand me? And came through blessed like that. Just like that, real time. It's been history. I've been fucking with these dudes since then, you know what I'm saying? My nigga G-Hood is on it. That touchdown is fucking amazing, bro. That is my favorite fucking song, bro. If you look on my Facebook Live.
That's the next video I'm gonna shoot. I was gonna shoot another one, but then I told myself, I said, nah, because Halloween came out so crazy.
Yeah.
I said, I gotta double back with Takedown.
If you look on every one of my Facebook Lives, like, just go up. If you just scroll up, you'll see, I start myself off with that song every day.
I appreciate that.
This nigga got touchdowns. I said, hook one, hook two, touchdown. Nigga, come around. Nigga, come around. You heard me?
No rap.
Nigga, you get gunned down. Nigga, started from the bottom. Now we up. Nigga, I love that song. I relate to that shit. That's like my theme song. You hear me? Like, real joke. That's like my theme song. That's how I started my shit. Because hook one, hook two, nigga, touchdown. Like, for real, bro, nigga, started from the bottom, now we up now. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just about, it's like where you came from, you know what I'm saying? It's about where you going, you understand me? That's why I tell these niggas out here I'm unstoppable with this shit. Because like I said, it's a method to the madness. You got to know what you're doing in life, you know what I'm saying, where you're trying to go. Because, you know what I'm saying, it's your vision. A lot of people ain't going to see your vision the way you see your vision. You know why? It's because a lot of people be, you know, people who doubt your vision. And people who doubt your vision, them is the ones who is just confused because they don't understand what's happening, what's in their face right now. You know what I'm saying? And I really think my nigga G-Hood is the absolute shit in this motherfucker.
Yeah.
And niggas around the world already know that because, like I said, I go from her to the Philippines, to France, to everywhere you can think. You can name a city, I'm going to say, yup.
Yeah.
We all over there. And they fuck
we
with this shit.
Worldwide, this bitch, man.
And they fuck with this G-Hood shit right here. And I ain't never a nigga to gas a nigga up, you understand me? Mm-hmm. Ever since I first heard this nigga, I said, damn, that nigga right there, he just got that style I like. You know what I'm saying? When I heard that nigga rap, because, you know, when you get to know people and you see they really about the shit that they rapping, you know what I'm saying? That gravitates you to that, but you be like, yeah, I fuck with this shit right here.
Yeah.
Because I know this nigga right here is the absolute 100% in everything that he's saying. You know what I'm saying? And what he's doing on these tracks. And that's why we always fuck with that shit up here on IOTBA Radio. We're going to make sure everybody, like I say, from the 214 to across the pond, my boy, understand who G-H60D is up in this motherfucker. You understand me? Real talk, Cloud 9, Money Gang, I'm still with the click. Killer Cal up in this motherfucker. Money Moke up in this motherfucker. Pack right up in this motherfucker. Piff up in this motherfucker. JG up in this motherfucker. EntitledKings.com up in this motherfucker. They got Entitled Legends. You know what I'm saying? You know, they gonna talk that shit. Like I say, I fuck with. You know what I'm saying? Because listen, man, I love all races. I love all races, you understand, man? That's real talk.
We a fucking
woman. Because I fuck with everybody, but when you see your own kind really trying to take advantage and prosper and do something, you know what I'm saying, that's positive to make a motherfucking change in their situation, we salute that on IOTBA. Yeah. And shit started. I want you to give everybody in this motherfucker a motherfucking hand clap for that goddamn. They work.
Yeah.
Everybody work. I see the drive. I see the determination. You understand me? Because it will take hard work and dedication. You see how G-Hood dropping these motherfucking CDs on them? He not playing.
Yeah,
you
I
see
got that? Another one coming after that. Probably New Year.
See?
G-Dollar. I got G-Dollar already done, but I still got to touch it up. It got to smash a whole bunch of
see what I'm saying? That's he not playing.
He got three.
Like, any dude who's doing anything, like, I don't rap no more.
I got like 18, 19, 20 shorts just sitting around.
But see, this right here, this type of shit right here, hearing them say, I'm going to drop this CD, I'm going to drop that CD, I'm going to drop this CD, it motivates me, you understand me? I ain't in his profession, but it motivates me to see how hard he working, because you know he working hard. But when you see somebody else working hard just like you, that make you want to work extra motherfucking hard. Yeah. G Hood, another motherfucking hand clap for that goddamn. G Hood showing y'all he ain't playing no games. He telling these niggas out here, if you rap, you better step your weight up. Yeah. Nigga, because I'm dropping them. Nigga, I'ma steady drop them on you to make these niggas out here feel this shit, you understand me? Cloud 9, Money Gang, you understand me? Empire. You understand me?
HeezyTV.com and TitleKings.com. Y'all better get in tune with this shit, man. This shit is serious.
Man, I ain't lying, Killer Kyle. I thought you was locked up, bro. Cause look.
I'm home now.
Look, oh, you just got home?
No, because, look, been home for some years now.
Look, I ain't seen you, bro. Look, I got your name on my list of the stuff I want to ask G-Hood. Yeah. Because I ain't seen you, bro. I'm telling you.
Nah,
I got Killer Kyle.
I was up here last time.
Nah, I know you was up here last time, but you know, I ain't just... You not really seeing you since. I was like, what my nigga Killer Kyle at? Cause we fuck with that. Fuck you, man. You understand me? Real talk, you know what I'm saying? We fuck with the whole squad. You understand me? Real talk. I was like, what? Cause I ain't seen my nigga. I was like, I want to see what my nigga Killer Kyle at. Money Gang, I'm happy my nigga Young Zen came up in this bitch tonight. Pack right up in this motherfucker, like real talk. So you can see me doing my thing, because you know what I'm saying? Young Zach, though, my thing.
And we proud of you. We was talking about that shit. Man. I was chopping. I was giving Heezy the game on you earlier. I'm like, man, bro, correct him. Like, said, fuck that job. So, like, he chased what he wanted to do, and now this shit working.
I'm proud of you,
man. Real talk.
So, I appreciate it, bro, because niggas seen where I came from and where I'm trying to go. Like I say, I ain't stopping. We done did a whole bunch of shit. You know what I'm saying? We done been out a cover and Boosie concert, VIP, Young Jeezy.
Yeah.
You understand
everywhere.
Me? VIP. You understand? I wake up every day like I ain't did a motherfucking thing. Do you understand me? Like, real talk, because I ain't did nothing. Because we just not scratching the surfaces of this shit. You know what I'm saying? Because that's just how you gotta be. But we fuck with G-Hood the Prayer. We gonna keep this shit on rotation. We got to get all the new music. Man, we got to get you. Yeah, we got to get you back up in here. Like, what name is Halloween? We got to get you in here. Like, real talk. We got to get you in here before Halloween.
Yeah.
You know, before Thanksgiving. So when's Halloween Thursday?
Halloween was yesterday.
No, I mean not Halloween. Thanksgiving.
Yeah, Thanksgiving.
I'm tripping.
Yeah.
I know. Like Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving on the Thursday. Thanksgiving always on the Thursday. So I know they're not gonna be. I know they're not gonna be open on Prayer on Thursday, but I know they're gonna be open. No win. I think that we can do it the day before and China referrals dropping in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Tell everybody where they can find you at the
end. Man, you can find me on Instagram at G H the number 6 the number 0 D at G here, so G H 6 O D. Like the number is zero, you know what I'm saying? So H60D, all together on Instagram, Twitter, all the same shit. Instagram and Twitter, you know what I'm saying? That's what you need to fuck with me for. You need to keep up with all the music. HeezyTV.com, HeezyTV.com, EntitledKings.com, y'all should know how to spell that, EntitledKings.com. You know what I'm saying? Like,
man, y'all niggas work some movement. Y'all all together, bro. That's how niggas gonna make it.
Yeah,
you know, usually you don't see niggas. That's what man say, bro. Usually you don't see that. That's how niggas is gonna make it. You gotta all work together, you understand me? Besides G-Hood, we really, really appreciate you coming back, showing love to IOTBA. You know what I'm saying? Because we always fuck with you up in here, because we really fuck with your music. Up in this motherfucker for real. Everybody around the world. Fuck with your music. Everybody, get G-Hood another big old motherfucking hand clap for coming to IOTBA with me.
I appreciate y'all having me.
So y'all know how we do. Y'all know how we do. We got my man JG coming back up from EntitledKings.com. We're going to get back into that. Talk about EntitledKings.com some more. And, you know, talk a little boxing shit because JG, he really loves that boxing shit. Like, we love that boxing shit.
Yeah.
And we finna get into it. It's finna be like the Clash of the Titans. You understand me? You know, I'm talking about JG. You know what I'm saying? Real talk. It's like running up an unstoppable hill fucking with me when they come to talking this boxing shit. Let's get it popping. Shut up the G-Hood up in this motherfucker. Y'all know how I do. Y'all know how I do. Mr. 2-1-4. And I'm on that bullshit again.